Welcome to iLecture Online. So why do Cepheid variables vary and why is their periodicity so constant? Every 5.4 days for this particular one, the delta Cephei in Cepheus varies in intensity from brightest to dimmest back to brightest every 5.4 days, and it's been doing that presumably for thousands of years. Is it because the amount of radiation being emitted from the core varies in that particular fashion? And that is unlikely. It's unlikely that the core emission of energy varies in that particular way, because it would be caused by perhaps running out of the available materials and then the core collapsing, and then of course the extra heat starts the fusion process over again, and maybe there's some variation that way. But we don't think that's the case. We think the case has more to do with the surface itself. So let's try to explain what we think is happening in these Cepheid variables. So here we have the Cepheid variable at its small size. The core is putting out enormous amount of energy, enormous amount of radiation, causing the pressure to build up inside the star. Now, the reason why the pressure is building up is because when the star is at its smallest, the surface tends to be more opaque to the radiation getting out. So radiation is being stored up inside the star, building up pressure, and that buildup pressure begins to expand the star. So the pressure builds up, the star is expanding, the size of the star is getting bigger, and then the extra radiation begins to increase the surface temperature of the star as well. Of course, as the surface temperature of the star increases, it begins to radiate more energy from the surface. Once it does that, the star begins to become brighter and brighter. And eventually, the increased surface radiation begins to cool the surface. So what we see here is that the star begins to be really bright because the temperature has increased to its maximum level. The star is also getting bigger. It's now 8% bigger than it was when it was smaller. And so now we have reached the maximum intensity of the star, the maximum brightness at the peak of its cycle. So now the extra radiation from the surface of the star begins to cool the temperature of the star down, and the luminosity of the star begins to decrease as well. But the star was at its maximum expansion rate, so both the momentum and the greater than average pressure inside the star continues to expand the star as the surface temperature is declining and as the radiation of the surface is declining as well. So in other words, the reason why the star still expands after the star has reached its maximum intensity is because, one, there's the momentum of the expansion of the star, because at that point the surface is moving at about 20-25 kilometers per second, and there's still greater than average pressure inside the star, continue to push against the sides of the star, continue to expand the star. But eventually, the amount of additional pressure is gone because the radiation of the star, the momentum stops, and now the star begins to collapse again. And as the star collapses, there's insufficient internal pressure to halt that collapse, and so the star is just collapsing, collapsing, collapsing. The surface now becomes more opaque again because it's now smaller, and more radiation begin to get trapped. As the radiation is trapped, the pressure is beginning to build up, and as the pressure begins to build up, the temperature begins to increase on its surface. But the buildup of the pressure begins to slow down the contraction until eventually so much pressure is built up that the contraction is stopped. And then the extra pressure begins to expand the surface again, and we're back to the initial stage of the star. So it has to do more with the amount of radiation that can escape from the surface, that can escape through the surface and away from the surface of the star. We can see that as the star is smaller, the opacity of the star is greater. As the star is bigger, the opacity of the star is less, and that's why the radiation gets trapped, expands the star, escapes the star contracts, and it does that in regular cycles like that. And that is why the cycles are so precise, 5.4 days for each cycle, because the star is expanding contraction due to the opacity and the capture radiation of the star, not necessarily to what is changing inside the core. And that's what explains why Cepheid variables have these regular intervals in their periodicity from bright to dim back to bright. That is why. Oh. Yeah, after not enough sleep, that's what we look like.